Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. In this video I'm gonna explain you faster RCNN and how you can use this with Pytorch. So let's begin. So RCNN basically stands for region based convolutional neural network. So it uses a regional proposal network, which basically means that it has a CNN backbone like ResNet 50, which it uses to get feature maps. Okay, so the feature maps basically captures all the spatial and other information, okay, and then on those feature maps it performs a sliding window operation which identifies whether a particular region in an image is background or is it likely to be an object, and then on the basis of that it creates some bounding boxes and assigns score to it. So in this way lots of bounding boxes are created, like hundreds or maybe even thousands for some scenario, okay, and then after many bounding boxes are created, most of it is reduced by using non-maximum suppression. So non-maximum suppression basically means that multiple bounding boxes are created, each has some confidence, right? So the confidence which are very low and the boxes which are overlapping, they are suppressed. So for example, let's say there is this bounding box and then there is another bounding box. This one has a higher confidence, this has a very low confidence, and they are like overlapping a lot, so this one will get discarded. So this is how non-max suppression works in simple terms, okay. So after filtering out all the unnecessary bounding boxes, there are some bounding boxes which are still left, which are called region proposals. Then those bounding boxes are then further passed on in the faster RCNN network, which then gives us the final bounding boxes with our object of interest. So this is how it works in simple words. So first we'll be importing Torch. And then from Torch Vision import models, we'll also be needing Python imaging library. So from that we'll be using the image function for reading images, and then after that we'll also be using matplotlib. We'll be needing a random library for creating some random colors, and we'll also be needing a function called patches for displaying our label. Then we'll write device equals to CUDA if torch dot CUDA dot is available, else CPU. So this means that if GPU configured in our system, so model should be using our GPU for processing. So you can see we have CUDA over here. Now if you don't have CUDA configured in a system, you can refer to one of my tutorials where I have shown how you can install PyTorch VS Code and get it configured with CUDA. Okay. Now we have this image, which is this image, okay. So we'll write img is equals to image dot open. So the image is located in this folder. So I've written os.part.join, and then we'll convert it to RGB. So we'll also have to import a OS library. So we'll write OS over here. And then we'll also be using transforms library. So now let's rerun it. So you can see we have our image over here. Next we'll try to transform our image into channel height width format. So we'll let transform is equals to transforms dot to tensor, and then we'll write img equals to transform, and then apply this function over our image. Then we'll try to see the shape of our image. So you can see these are the dimensions. Next we'll be defining a variable called weights, which we'll be using in our model. So we'll write model is equal to models dot detection dot faster RCNN resident 50 FPN weights equals to weights. Then we'll also see which classes, which different types of classes does it contain. So we'll write weights dot meta categories . So let's execute this. So you can see we have successfully, imported our model, and these are the pre-trained weights, and these are the classes. So after this, we'll add image tensor equals to image dot unsqueeze, image dot unsqueeze at 0 dimension. This means that we are adding one singular dimension at 0th position, and then we'll put the model in the evaluation mode since we are performing inference. Now for performing inference, we'll be writing toy.inference mode. This is a slightly modified version of torch.nograd mode. So after that, we'll have predictions equals to model of image tensor, and we'll get the first item in the list. Actually, there is only one item. There is no item at index place one. So let's print this. So you can see these are our predictions. And these are the bounding boxes basically. These are the labels, and these are the scores. Next, we'll try to plot it using matplotlib. So PLT or subplots. We'll be using only one window, okay? Since there is only one image that we have to show. Hence, we'll write one over here. And this will be the size of the image. ax.imshow image. So here, we'll make a slight change. We will write image over here. And then image over here as well. Here we have created a label color dictionary so as to maintain different color for each class. So we'll write a for loop over here for box comma label comma score in zip comma prediction labels comma predictions scores. As you can see, we are using these keys from predictions, okay? And here we'll write a condition if score is greater than 0.6, and then we'll try to store the box, box points in the variables x1, y1, x2 and y2. Okay. And now we'll try to assign it a color. If this particular label is not in this dictionary, then we'll write label color and the name of the label, label class, and this particular random color will be assigned to a particular to this particular label. So next time in the next for loop, if this same label reappears, then it won't go into this if condition and assign it a new color. It will reuse the old color. Okay. Then we'll write rect equals to patches dot rectangle. So this will draw the bounding boxes. Here we have to give the starting point of the bounding box, and then this represents the width and this represents the height. This represents how thick your bounding boxes will be. This will be the color of the bounding box, and this means that whether you want to color the entire bounding box in the middle as well. So in this case, we just have to draw a normal bounding box without filling it completely. So hence we have kept it as none. Next, we'll try to add this rectangle to our axis using ax.add patch rect. Then we'll try to print the name of our label using ax.text. So this will be the position where the text will be. So the text will be at the top left corner of our bounding box, okay? And this will be the text that will be displayed. So here we'll be displaying the class name and the score, corresponding confidence score. The color of the text will be white and the color of the bounding box will be red. So it means that it will be filled with red color with white text, and it will be transparent with 50% alpha channel. So alpha channel represents the transparency. Now let's run this. So you can see this is our output. So you can see it has identified most of the things correctly. So here it detected the backpack, but here it missed it. Then here and over here it identified the car properly. Here it identified the bus properly, but I think it misidentified it as a truck as well. Well, we could get rid of it by increasing our threshold confidence score. So let's keep it 0.70. So if you put 0.7 over here and then try to, you know, rerun our program. So you can see it has gotten rid of that lower confidence score where it was also detecting this as a truck. So this is how you can use RCNN, faster RCNN on PyTorch, using its inbuilt module. So I hope you found my video helpful. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much.